Hey guys, Tarek with Cyclone FPV. Getting ready to do an RMA here. Let me show you what I got. Let's see. Are we going to charge, what'd you say? 25 bucks?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, like.
Just like you get everything pushed through in the invoice and sent out.
Is that what we have? Yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah, I guess so. Right. I mean, it's that the checkout, I don't think, is on there as what could happen. You know, you have to check the thing and see if that's the case. Because if not, then it's like, they can say, well, that didn't say that. So, can you check for me?
Uh-huh.
Please? All right. All right, so let's see what we got here. We've got it's here. All right. So apparently all the settings were wiped on this one. So we're going to go ahead and configure this and set it up for the customer. He was just trying to get it connected, and then somehow, I don't know, there was an issue. So we're going to go ahead and get this iFlight set up. First things first, let's go ahead and plug this in and see what we have going on the computer screen. Hey, babe, what RMA is that one? Do you know? Do you have it in front of you? Or you know what? I can look it up. I've got his name. That's all right. I got his name. Okay. All right, so let's plug this into Betaflight. Let's see what's going on, shall we? Firmware's right, actually. Oh, okay, so let's see what firmware we got on here. That's not gonna be good. Oh my gosh, can't type. No. Let's look at the paperwork that came with this from iFlight. See if they give us a target. I would just not do anything.
Okay.
And just charge them shipping. And then remind me and I'll go back and do that.
Okay.
Okay, so do we have any documentation on the target? Here we go. All right, well, looks like we're off to the internet then. Let's go to iFlight. Oh, it's right there on the box. Okay, never mind. Let's see if we can do that. So apparently the target for this is going to be, let's go to firmware update. iPhone. Okay. Let's go here.
Hello.
Forget I'm so we're going to go ahead and reset this first. And I'm wondering, while we're doing that, if they have like a, let's see, there. Is my mom trying to call you?
No.
Hello. What's up, Mom? How you doing? Uh-oh. We're going to have to put you down, Sandra. Oh, not much. I'm on a live build, so everybody on the internet can hear you right now. So I will call you back as soon as I get done. All right, bye. She's like, nope, hang up. Okay. All right, so let's see. Do we get any kind of a target? Nope. Oh, here's what's this? Factory dump. Yes, let's see. Beta flight, don't flash unified targets, caution, factory dumps. Copy R. Okay, so let's see. What is this? All right. Battery dump right here. Let's open these up. Let's go to the BTX table first. Oh man, what the hell is on here? Let's see, do they give us a BTX? Let's see, F4. Who's the force? All right, so we're going to take these two. Let's cut these. Go to software downloads. Oh no. Shit. I guess my computer's not on the internet, huh? Thanks to the internet going down.
Wonderful.
That's awesome.
You got
up
the paste.
Let's try this again. Let's cut again. Here. Okay, go to customer files. New folder. And the RMA number on this is. Dun, dun, dun. Why don't I have an RMA number on here? Do you have the RMA number for this one? What's an RMA number? Thank you. Connect, apply custom defaults, connect, okay, this, look at that, all our stuff is back now, good. Now, let's see, configuration, you know what, let's do this, let's go to here first, that's the BTX table, let's go to the factory dumps, and then factory dumps here, and then we're going to go to the NAS. Here. Whoops, no, this one. NAS qualified analog. And the F. Ooh, which one did you get? F4. let's see, he got the V2 4S. So that's going to be V2 4S, and he got S plus RXSR right here. Go ahead and do a double click, edit, select all, copy here, here, CLI, here, paste, enter. Here we go. Transmitter out. We're using a jumper. Okay, let's connect. Okay, reset, calibrate, see if it puts our VTX, and it does, and it looks like everything else is good. So now we should be able to, okay, what do we got here? Okay. Let's go to configuration. S bus is right. Let's go to receiver. All right, let's see if we can find this. It looks like it's bad.
Receiver still connected.
Yeah, it is connected. Go. Let me see. That's going to interrupt our video feed, so I'm going to have to disconnect this. So let me see if I can just go to this VTX here. And I think what we'll do is go to race band. Let me see. E5. Drop the power 20%. Click save. Let's see if this interrupts our signal still. Nope, looks good. Okay, so let's see what's going on with the receiver. We do not have any function on the receiver at all. It says we are bound, but that's external. Well, now wait a minute. Why would you have external? Oh, he's got internal as well. Okay, so external's off. Let's turn off. Let's go see our ports. Okay. It's okay. I'm just, it doesn't seem like it's on the port, so I'm going to try to look at the pictures. See if I can find out how they would have done this. This looks weird. Oh god, I don't know. Let's see if we try. No, that's their ESC. Doesn't make sense. Let's go to the motors. Let's see if their ESC is working.
Did you get
100? Yes.
Would you want a sandwich?
Sure.
Something else.
No, it's fine. Very sandwich is fine. It's not fine. This is wacky stuff here. So they don't have this connected that way. What the hell? So he's got an RXSR, but they didn't wire it the way their manual says. So that doesn't make any sense. Let's go to their manual. This is irritating. So the manual says that the RXSR would be... No, the RXSR is right. Hold on a second. Going to here. Let's see. Let me turn this off. Not how they wired this. They lied to me, babe. Look at that. I mean, that was an error on iFlight side. So iFlight sent the configuration to be F port, but left the wire connected to S bus and not the S port. So therefore you could not run it. So what we did is we pulled the wire out and reset it, and there you go. Problem solved. Gentleman now has all his functions. It's not his fault, poor guy. I mean, sucks, you know? I mean, he had to send it in because they didn't do their part right. That's an iFlight issue. Apologize for that. But guys, if you have any more of you have something like this, that would be what you check first. So what we did is, you'll see the wire harness here. In their diagram online, right, on their instructions right here, it shows you that it should be coming to this third one to run F-port on RXSR. What they did is they removed this one, and they had this yellow wire put into the S-bus out instead. So you had two conflicting protocols there, and two conflicting configurations. This did not match the wiring. However, this does. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and go in beta flight, and we are going to take the CLI, and we are going to do a dump file here. Okay, and we're going to save this for the customer, so at least he has that. Copy. All right, we got it fixed. Mama. Oops. Okay. Oh, I forgot you guys could see that. But anyways, what I was saying here, and I'll show you again. So what I was saying was, is on the file, if you look at this file here, he has RXSR, and that F port is right there because that's where the S port is. What they did, though, is they actually had it in the S bus. So we had to take that receiver out, take the plug out, and pop this wire out and put it back in F port, and then it was fine. So they sent it out of there incorrectly. We're going to paste this here, the file, save as, and we'll go put this in his folder. That's not it. Which one was it? I gotta remember now. So it's, let's go here and then go back. 5631. Okay, so let's go to 5631, which is right here. I'm gonna paste. I will save it as dump file F port correct. I think I spelled that wrong. All right, so let's do that. And then let's take, let's close that out. Let's close that out. And now let's go back and disconnect. Reconnect. And let's go to his modes. Let's go to receiver. You got no switches set. Oh my goodness, sir. You have no switches set. Okay. So now we have to do this part. Okay, so on the T18, let's see. Should be pretty much the same like everything else. He's got arm as what? Oh, I didn't even see what it was. We're going to edit. Yeah, shut up. Here, we did so. There you go. SA will be arm. Okay, let's get back. Let's do this one. B mode. There. See if we get stick movement now. Let's go to receiver. Look at that. Now we got stick movement. Bring our throttle down. Let's go to modes. Our arm switch will be here. We'll take, I don't know what the hell this is, high. And then we'll take our flight angle. Okay, which will be this. Let's delete that. Let's add a range. Okay, so we'll make angle, make horizon. Horizon will be here. Angle will be there. And we'll add a range for fail safe. Okay, this is fail. We'll add a range for the beeper. Okay. And then we will add a range for angle mix. Actually, no, we don't want that one. Not that one. We want FPV. We want trainer. Acro trainer. Put that here. Okay, and click save. There you go. And we're done. Now, we can go to motors. Put our quad out here. Come down here. Flip this button. And let's see if we can get this to work. There we go. Now we're not getting any telemetry. So let's go to configuration. There we go. Now let's make sure one spins. Yep, two spins. Yep, three spins. Yep, and four spins. Three. Perfect. That's it. So we will again. We're done. Nice job. That's good. All right, bud. That's it for your radio. You're going to be good. So remember, it's going to be arm, mode, fail safe. That's all she wrote. Go ahead and power that off. Shut that down. You're good to go. All right, let me turn this off. All right, guys. So look, that pretty much wraps it up. Everything else is good around here. If you have any questions, let me know. Also, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. I always appreciate you. If you need help with your drone, you can always send it in or hit us up online. We'll give you an RMA ticket. You send it in and we'll take care of it for you, okay? Other than that, guys, God bless. Be safe. Remember, go spend time with your family, guys. You never know how much time you have left. So go make the most of it. You can always fly later. We'll talk to you soon.